Hi, I'm Richard Polonetsky.
I'm Alan Steinfeld, and thank you for watching today.
Thank you for watching today, and today is a special treat, because today we're going to be doing movie reviews.
My favorite thing is to watch a movie, to crawl up in the dark with hundreds of people, or a few, and just be fed reality from another point of view.
Now you ask, well, why would you guys be doing movie reviews? Well,
I love movies, that's why.
I do too. Okay. And but it goes beyond that, because Alan has created an amazing television show for the last 20 plus years. He hosts it, he films it, he does it all. So he knows a bit about making TV, making film.
And Richard has worked with some of the best people in television, Barbara Walters on The View.
I've had the privilege of making a lot of television shows, a lot of films over a long career in the industry. And we came together and decided, you know what?
Yes, we were just at the Hamptons Film Festival, and it was an incredible showcase of new movies coming out. And we're going to talk to you about some of those movies we saw in the Hamptons.
Yeah, and the special thing about it as well was that it was the 25th anniversary of the Hamptons International Film Festival. And really, there was a great energy there, and I would say also, you know, the diversity of the films was really engaging this year as well.
This is an international film festival, and the movie that I think we should start with is the one that closed the festival.
Yeah, I think that's a great one to start with. It was I, Tonya.
About Tonya Harding, the disgraced figure skating champion, and her story is fantastic. The ups and downs, how she was pushed to be a skating star by an abusive mother. I mean, the film was a bit tongue-in-cheek, though. It was not a straight drama. There's a lot of humor in there, but it's sort of like a dark humor, you know? And yet they're telling this woman's story, which is a sort of tragic story. How she was brought up to be this figure skater, and then scandal followed her.
Yeah, it you're exactly right. And the interesting thing was, I thought it was very well done.
Incredibly well directed.
Great job. The casting was superb. Margot Robbie was just phenomenal.
Margot Robbie is going to win an Academy Award, or at least be nominated.
Would be shocking if she wasn't nominated. I mean, she was really amazing. I mean,
she takes acting to another level.
Whole other level.
Physical, emotional, spiritual, traumatized. She does it all in this movie. This is a world-class performance I've ever seen of an actress.
Absolutely right. And if she does not get an Academy Award nomination for this, something is very, very wrong.
So, I think she's going to win the Academy.
I think she will as well.
I predict that right here on this show.
Yes, we predict.
November 2017.
That's right. Will win.
Yes.
The Academy Award as Best Actress.
Absolutely. You heard it here first.
Yeah.
So the thing that made this film is so interesting is that the actors broke down the fourth wall and they talked to the screen about their life. So this is really a recreation of the ups and downs of the life of Tonya Harding, but it's an intense movie. It's a great movie. It puts you on the edge. Even though you know what happens, it puts you on the edge of your seat. And
Craig Gillespie, the director, brilliant Australian director, he did a really, really great job in kind of molding the tragedy, if you will, of Tonya's personal story, as well as what ensued, you know, with Nancy Kerrigan, etc. But also there was vast amounts of humor in there. It's fast moving, a never lull.
I told you before, what bothered me about this movie is that poor Tonya Harding exploited all her life by the media. This is, in a way, another level of exploitation. It's a great movie, but I feel like, you know, they're taking someone's life and exploiting it. And that bothered me about the movie, despite the incredible performance. It probably will be Academy Award nominated, but it was just that little piece, like, this is a real person they're laughing at, making fun of, and
yeah.
You know, also validating, in a sense, they show a heroic status that she engaged in to overcome huge obstacles of family abuse, spouse abuse, to become this sort of great figure skater. But it was still a little tough to
watch. It was tough. You know, but you know what was interesting in that It was very educational in the sense that you really got a very deep glimpse into her life and really how disadvantaged she was within the realm of figure skating. It almost seemed like she never had a fair shot for the fact that she came from a poorer background and didn't have all the fancy clothes and didn't have the upper crest upbringing, that she was never given a fair shot by the judges. The judges even told her straight out that, you know,
no matter... You have to look like a figure skater.
Right, that she wasn't representing what they wanted to embody as a figure skater, even though... She was skating and performing maneuvers like a triple axis jump that
she
no one else could do.
She was the first woman to do a triple axel. I didn't know that until I saw the movie.
Exactly. So it really was educational in a way to really, you do really empathize with her story. It's a great learning
and
experience.
And Margot Robbie was so amazing. You actually see her ice skating and doing, you think, these triple axels. I mean, the way it's shot and done and produced and directed, excellent and fun. It was definitely
fun
to watch.
Lots of laughs. But, and it flowed, right? It just moved.
I don't want to be laughing at someone's life. That's right. But, you know, that's my conflict. That's, you know, I hope you enjoy the movie, but still.
No, and that's a beautiful, emphatic, and you know, and conscious way of looking at it. But overall, I'd recommend people to see it just because it's a great movie. It's informative. It's fun. It moves fast. And there's tremendous acting and directing.
Yeah, it's worth seeing Margot Robbie be so diverse, so present, so much this character. She's probably more a character than Tonya Harding herself. You know, she's
possibly
more expressive. So. Yeah. Recommend seeing it.
It's just an incredibly fun, amazing, insightful ride.
So that's our films for this round of film review. I hope you enjoyed that. And we want your comments and feedback. And if you have some films you want reviewed, get in touch with us.
So just leave your comment below or send us a message through the channel.
And we're going to have a lot more film reviews because I love film. I love points of view. I love the perspective you're getting that you would normally get unless you saw a movie. So thanks for watching tonight and see you at the movies.
Thanks for watching.
Didn't someone enjoy use
the
that
show.
Line, see you at the movies?
I think that was
Cisco and, you know, and Ebert. Yeah.
Who are they?
I always loved Ebert, actually.
Who?
Ebert.